explore the characteristics of cats, big and small, at the Field Museum.
Cats, Predators to Pets is an interactive exhibit with a perfect blend of science, history, and even pop culture. Anastasia joins us with more. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
Yes. Okay, so tell us about this exhibit.
So the exhibit encompasses both cats in the wild, so big predator cats, lions, tigers, etc., but also the cats that we have in our home, little domestic cats, how they behave, how they're similar to wild cats.
And that's what's so unique, because when you do learn a little bit more about them, it's like they kind of domesticated themselves, right?
Well, a little bit. So about 10,000 years ago, around the Fertile Crescent, cats were wandering around villages looking for food, and we were welcoming them, you know, to keep the mice away. So, you know, we had a good partnership, I would say.
So that's what it was.
Yeah.
And the rest is history. Mm-hmm. Now they're in homes everywhere.
Yeah.
So this exhibit really takes a look at not only that history, but also the cat diversity. I mean, how many cats are we talking about here?
So it's debatable,
yeah.
But we say there's about 45 species of cats.
Wow. What? Look at this.
Incredible. Okay, and that ranges from very big cats to like very tiny, even really tiny wild cats out there too.
Yeah, absolutely. One of my favorites in the exhibition is the black-footed cat. It's really, really small. It looks like a kitten, and it's the deadliest cat. Yes, I would highly recommend looking some videos up about this cat. It's
like, it's just
going
to pounce on you or
yeah,
what?
It eats a lot of lizards
horrifying.
And smaller
animals
and things like that. So it's very effective.
But you said smaller than a kitten and all
it's
that
about
cuteness.
That size, yeah.
Yeah, and that's the thing. And the thing is like, in a way, we say that our pet cats are domesticated, but in a way, they kind of never are. Like, they seem a little bit wild. They have all those characteristics of hunting and, you know, all those things.
I mean, a lot of people who go through the exhibition see the big cats and how they interact, like how they catch prey and things like that, and they recognize their own cats in there as well.
Oh,
and,
wow.
Yeah, and you can see the similarities.
And there's a little bit with conservation efforts as well. Are we talking about with some of the bigger cats?
Yeah, absolutely. So, big and small. So, okay. We have some conservation efforts with the Florida panthers, which are a large cat, but also with the pampas cats, which you find in South America. One of our curators works with them, and he discovered that they were actually 5 different species when they were thought to be one.
Wow. Okay. Do we have wild cats in Illinois anywhere?
Yeah. You know, they're cougars, things like that. You know,
really?
Cougars in Illinois? Where?
Mountain lions. You know, they can come down. If you guys never heard of that, sometimes they're out in the wilderness, so
okay.
They don't really like people, and that's probably for the best.
So. All right. Good to know. Okay. Well, speaking about the little mountain cat in my own home, you guys have incorporated people's precious pets into this exhibit, right?
Yeah, that's my cat interactive. So every month we have a different theme and we invite people to submit their cats.
Oh, stop it. Look at this.
And the top cats make their way into the exhibition where people can scroll through all the pictures from all the months. And it's really, we've got some really, really cute cat videos and pictures and it's been great.
So then when you come to the exhibit, you will see your cat photo?
If you win the competition.
Oh my gosh.
Are you surprised about how many entries you've had from people?
You know, I think that I wasn't surprised. It was a lot of entries, but I knew that people love their cats, and part of the reason that's why we did the exhibition, so I wasn't surprised.
I'm sure you've learned so much about cats, and you probably already knew a lot, but what's the most interesting thing that you were like, huh? Didn't know that.
I actually think that the cat I mentioned previously, the black-footed cat, just that it is so effective. What you learn is that cats are actually not super effective at catching, like, lions and tigers.
Oh.
Their success rate is actually pretty low, but for these smaller cats, they're way more efficient. They're actually much deadlier, and I think that is really fun.
What is it about them that makes them more efficient?
You know, I'm not quite sure exactly. I think a big part of it is that, like, they're smaller animals, and especially the black-footed cat, it hunts at night, so a lot harder to see it.
And of course, cats can see at night. They've got that good night laser eye vision.
Exactly. That's talk about those senses.
I know,
yeah.
Exactly.
Crazy.
Well, incredible. I mean, I have to tell you, if you are lucky enough to live with a cat, you end up being domesticated by them because they own you.
Yeah.
So you end up being their servant. So a good range of personality. So really excited to see this exhibit. Thank you so much for being with us.
Of course.
You can check out Cats, Predators to Pets at the Field Museum through April 27th. For tickets and more information, just head to fieldmuseum.org/visit or find them on social media.
I can't believe you have not submitted Sasha yet.
You know what? She would win too easily. That's the problem.
You gotta make it fair for everybody.
Give everybody else a chance.